Hey guys, I'm Hulis Neko. Have you ever wanted to create a visual novel in Roblox but legitimately had no idea on where to start? Are you also looking for an easy engine as well in order to make this a reality? Some examples including this, this, and that? A friend of mine who goes by Steven Scripps has created his Steven's Visual Novel Engine, a free, beginner-friendly engine used to create visual novels. The goal of the engine is to allow anyone with experience in an art program or image editing software to be able to easily pick up and create their own visual novel engine, even without any prior programming experience. It comes with these features as well: basic saving and loading system, automatic theme customization, full rich text support for bold, italics, etc., backgrounds, covers, sprites, and title cards, simple, intuitive, sound playing system for sound effects and background music. This video will be separated into chapters, with one being the demo place included in the dev forms and the other will be the basic setup for the visual novel engine. Enjoy! Hey y'all, so this is going to be the demo place that I'm going to provide with a link down in the description below. This is going to be how it looks like when you put in everything inside Roblox Studio, which I'll cover in the next chapter. So you have the new game button, continue, chapter select that you're able to, you know, select chapters, and of course, settings bar. Start a new game now. Chapter 1, feature demo.
Hello world!
Whoa, check out this, a bold text. Hey! Which one of these colors do you like the most? Red, green, or blue? And of course, what color should I pick? And you have the options to select colors as well. So, I'll choose red. I like red. Yep. I'll keep that in mind. Check out these curtains. Alright. I'm tired of these. I'm tired of them now. What feature should I show off next?
Whoa!
What was that? Did you see that? We gotta get out of here. And scene switch. That was close. Huh? Where are we? You're at Noob HQ. Hey! Is this Noob HQ? That's right. I need to get some information. You're gonna have to get through me first. Bring it on. What the heck is going on? Crash. Bang, pow, pow. Ow. Come back when you're stronger. What a fight. By the way, I remember your favorite color is red. Oh. Click on me to continue. Boom. So, you're able to select now. I'm gonna click on the NPC. You did it. Thank you. Oh. And now chapter 2, the outro.
Hi, Steven.
Hey, Steven Scripps here. Thanks for trying out my visual novel engine. That's all the demos I have for now. If you need help figuring out how to use this engine, make sure to look at the tutorials and documentations in the README script. This will be covered in the next chapter after this. I'll send you back to chapter 1 now. Good luck on your visual novel. Also, you're able to save into these empty slots over here. You're able to load it. But of course I'll lose all the progress. So this entire scene is just gonna be reset. Auto. That just auto completes the text and you're able to change the background music, sound effects, the scroll speed of the text, and other stuff. So if I click on this, it just sends me back. All the way back to chapter 1. Oh, hi again. And yeah, that's the demo. I'm going to send you off into the Roblox studio and I'll show you how to set up everything. And the rest is up to you. Thanks. Hi everyone, and welcome to chapter 2. I'm going to be explaining the basic setup for the visual novel engine along with showing you how to create your very first scene and chapter. So in Roblox Studio, let's just open up a base plate down here. And using the model, the Steven's visual novel engine that I'm going to link down below in the description, we're going to insert it into our low place. So block contains everything that we need. Just put it anywhere, or you could just, you know, delete the block entirely. It really doesn't matter. So over here, we start ungrouping everything. So in replicated storage, we go over here, replicate storage, and click Control U together. to ungroup it. Service script service. Control U. Started GUI. Control U. And in starter player scripts, go here, starter player scripts. We grab this, put into starter player scripts, ungroup, and then workplace, go up here and just ungroup in it. We have everything set up. There is a very important step that you're gonna have to do first right now, which is inside the making your first story. Actually, no, it's inside getting started. My bad. So what we want to do right now is click Alt and P. We're gonna have to make this, we're gonna publish our game right now. So let's just create it. I'll just leave it untitled game. Create the place. Perfect. Now we wait. Setting up the place. And now once we have this, we're going to go into home, game settings, security, and enable students access to API services. Pretty much the reason why he's doing this is it allows you to test save data in Roblox Studio. So we just click save here. And we're done. So we could just close this and let's make our very first story. Inside our workspace, we're going to go inside to starter player scripts. And we're going to disable the demo. The demo is the same exact demo from chapter 1. And it tells you all the code that pretty much that he used in order to do it. Such as, hey, is this Noob HQ? That's right. Information, dialogue, play sounds, dialogue, other stuff like that. So we're going to disable this. Go into the properties and disable the behavior. All right, go into starter player scripts and put in a local script. Perfect. Now what we're going to do first is to start using it, create a local script and copy the code into here. It's responsible for loading the visual novel script, which contains every single tool in order to create your very first story. So we go here. Oops, my bad. We have this down here. So in our code sample, we're going to create our very first scene using a function. So function, my first scene, you call this whatever, like hello or hello one, hello S, whatever. We're just going to call it my first scene to follow through perfectly. Now, once we have this, this is going to be our scene. And let's just put in a little dialogue. So we grab this. VNM. Dialogue is just going to be hello world. And once we have all of this, we just call the function my first scene in order to play it out. So we go click play. Perfect. Hello world. But here's the thing. If we go to menu and we try clicking new game. Nothing works. Empty saves. No chapters. Because this is just an empty scene. There's no chapters at all to wrap it around the scene. Think of it as like a sandwich. Pretty much. So, to continue on. Here. It won't work. Yeah, missing a lot of critical features. New game doesn't work. Chapter select is empty. And we can't save and load. So, what we're going to do is that we're going to delete the little execute function line that we have here. And we're going to register a scene. So down here, VNM, register scene. The scene name is going to be called my first scene. And the scene function is going to be called my first scene. And now once we register a scene, we're going to have to put it inside the chapter. So down here, we're going to register a chapter. The chapter name is going to be called my first scene. The chapter number is going to be chapter 1. And the scenes is going to contain my first scene, which is this down here. This entire thing. So now once we have everything down, this is how it's supposed to look like. So we can just copy and paste this just in case I messed it up. And since we registered chapter 1, we can now use the new game button to play our chapter and all other features should be functional. So down here, go back, click play. New game. Perfect. Chapter 1, my first scene. Hello world. Done. Chapter select works as well. We could continue on. Stuff like that. Chapter 1. My first scene. Hello world. We could save this into here. We could keep on just saving. Auto. Everything works now. And yeah. That's pretty much it. This goes way into depth later. It's down here inside of the actual engine itself. So you could learn how to make sprites, backgrounds, sounds, customization, choices, and other stuff. So I hope you have fun with this engine that Steven Scripts made, and I can't wait to see what everyone makes now later on. Later.